Welcome everyone to a first impressions video of Babylon. And today I'm joined by my special guest, Unseen Whispers, so say hello.
What's up, man? How you doing?
Hey, I'm doing well. Thank you for joining me for what is a very unique show so far.
Yeah, I'd actually never even heard of this one until you mentioned it to me.
Yeah, it's like based off of a novel, which is very different, and just, we'll talk about this more later, but it's like very not like most anime.
Just to give a quick little thing, to me it was extremely similar to, like, Case Files or something like that, just anime form.
Okay, yeah, I can see that, like a Law & Order type show, if you've ever seen one of those. Okay, do you want to just go over the synopsis of the show?
Yep, I'm just going to read it directly from my anime list so I don't leave anything out. But here we go.
Go for it.
So, Babylon. It is a mystery thriller. In the newly formed Shinki District of Tokyo, Zen Sasaki is a diligent public prosecutor at the Tokyo District Public Prosecutor's Office. Assigned to a case involving false advertisement, Zen, along with his assistant officer, Atsushiko Fumio, investigate Japan Supri, a pharmaceutical company that had provided fabricated clinical research on the company's new drug. While investigating the file, Shin Inaba, an anesthesiologist connected to the crime, the case takes a dark turn when Zen finds a page stained with a mixture of blood, hair, and skin, along with the letter F scribbled all across the sheet. As he investigates further, the case goes beyond Zen's imagination and becomes vastly complex, challenging his sense of justice and his knowledge of the truth.
Yeah, so as you can tell from the summary, there's a lot going on here. Did you have any, like, idea what to expect when you first started the show? Like, did you guess at all where it would be going?
So, to be completely honest, whenever you told me about this one, and I was all game for going over it, I read the synopsis here, and I was honestly kind of disappointed with what I was going to have to watch. But then, after the first episode, I was most definitely intrigued, but I still would never have guessed where it went on episode 2 and 3.
Yeah, that's how I was too. Like, I was thinking, okay, thriller, I like this type of shows, a show that we could cover on my channel, so like, let's give this one a try. And then I didn't really know where it would be going. The first episode, I honestly found to be really boring and like hard to follow. But then after he found, what was his name? Fumio's death, I was like, okay, that's really unexpected. I'm curious now where it's going to be going. And then I really liked the next two episodes.
Yeah, I agree. I was actually entertained for the majority of the first bit, like the first episode. But yeah, as you mentioned, whenever you got that shocker of Fumio's death, it was just like, I was all in. I was like, this show's for me.
Yeah, like, I thought Fumio was the main character because, like, he's a young person. He's figuring out this world of prosecution and all that. So, like, then he's just like, you don't kill your main character.
Yeah, and they had a perfect contrast going between Fumio, like, this newly young inspirational type character, and Sasaki, like, the old veteran who already knows all the ropes. It was just a nice contrast to see, and then they just got rid of it.
Yeah, it's like, you have your perfect setup here. I could see, like, maybe Sasaki would die, and that would really prepare Fumio forward. But this was the complete opposite, so, like, very unique, and it kept my interest.
You said, talked about the first episode being slow. Did episodes 2 and 3 end up feeling the same way for you?
They definitely felt kind of slow, but not in a bad way. Like, sometimes when I'm watching anime, like, I just wanted to get over with. That's kind of how I felt for the first episode. But the second one is, like, slowly going through everything, so I was intrigued by that.
Yeah, they do a very good job of, like, depicting what detective work is like for this man. Like, instead of just giving us details and, like, kind of foreshadowing, we literally learn things as soon as he learns them.
Yeah, and that's true. Like, we never really get outside of his point of view, so that makes the twist in what he learns, like, really natural.
But, yeah, I found this very hard to follow, so I don't think a younger audience is going to really care for this one. But I think if you have a more mature, and you're looking for an anime that's really going to take some thought and really draw you in, this will be it. But you gotta be prepared for that, the slow pacing it has.
Yeah, don't expect it to follow, like, normal anime storytelling. It's, like, really pretty obvious, like, where it's going, who the characters are, and all that. This is, like, very much against that, which I enjoy the variety because I watch so many, like, cliche anime. And while I enjoy those, I like something different from time to time.
Agreed. Anime just gets too mainstream sometimes. Like, you gotta find something different.
Exactly. So this, I will definitely enjoy watching the rest of this. Something else that was a surprise is that how we got the first three episodes all at once.
Yeah. I invited you to go over an anime and watch one episode with me, and you're like, hey, the anime I wanted you to watch now has three episodes. And I was like, yeah, sure, let's do that now.
But I think I understand why they did it this way, is because, like, the first episode, you really don't get much about what's going on, and while there's a hook in the end with Fumio's death, it's not something that could really, like, withstand, like, a week wait, I think. So by having the second episode right in front of me, after I saw that, I could go watch that. and by the end of episode 3 is like they've really set up a good foundation to interest me in seeing the rest of it.
Yeah, I agree completely. And to compound on all of that, like at the end of every episode, like episode 1, you see Fumio's death and that's like the hook. And like you're here to watch it and it just kind of shifted your focus on where you thought it was going. And then by the end of episode 3, it just broadened your horizons and where I thought it was going after episode 1, it's just they're not going there now. Episode 3 completely changed my mind again.
Yeah, and they have that whole thing in episode 3 with the people jumping to their death and the idea of, like, death being something that humanity can control and harness. And I'm wondering, like, how they'll take that idea. Will it just be the idea of, like, it's good for people to be willing to die just to, like, move on from life? Or is there something, like, more to that? Because it's, like, a really weird thing in the way that they're doing it.
Yeah, and the way they're setting it up, that I don't remember her name, but the girl who's supposedly convincing all these people to die, do you have her name?
Magase, I think?
Yeah, something like that. But I'm really curious to see, how is she convincing them? Like, does she know something about the afterlife that nobody else does?
Yeah, and one of my questions about this is, like, is there a supernatural bend to this? Is it just, like, purely realistic with, like, it's all psychological and all that?
Yeah, I don't know. Either way, you have me hooked on a show now that I was not expecting to. I gotta fit this into my schedule somehow.
Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna watch this weekly because it's, like, so dense. I don't think I'd be able to follow it well.
That's a very good point. I'm probably gonna look into that, too, now that you mention it. It just seems like it'd be a better story to binge.
Yeah, I'm also someone who tends to, like, binge the, like, a real suspenseful anime, like, things like Attack on Titan, watch, like, a season at a time instead of an episode weekly.
For me, I like to binge them, but because of, like, I'm sure you know this, because of the whole YouTube factor now, like, we're almost forced to watch stuff on a weekly basis.
Yeah, I kind of try resisting that, but there are some shows that I just said, okay, I'm going to watch this weekly to cover, but then they also have, like, a backlog, like, 20 shows from this year I want to watch by the end of it, so this one will definitely be one of them.
Then another deep aspect of this show is, like, what does justice mean? So what do you think our main character's justice is, and what do you think justice is for yourself?
Well, it seems like his justice is, like, enforcing the law to protect the, like, the weak and vulnerable, which definitely, I'd say that's, like, a good surface level of it. But then there are the ideas that were especially, like, brought up in the interrogation that everyone's views of justice and what is right should be different. So how do you reconcile two different views? Is it just respecting and disagreeing, or are there cases where that's even possible? So then what do you do?
Yeah, and I like how the main character right now, how, like you mentioned, he just wants to strictly follow the law. Like, he's literally been thrust into a situation where he either follows the law one way and he can't follow it the other. Like, he can't follow the law entirely in the situation he's in, and I find that to be very intriguing.
Yeah, especially, like, when we have, like, Itsuki, who is the new mayor, and, like, everything that he's doing, like, he is legally in charge of the city, but he's just doing these morally wrong things, perhaps, by encouraging all these suicides. What does someone who wants to follow justice do when, like, there's so many conflicting morals trying to push him in different directions?
And does justice change based on the law? Because to our main character, Sasaki, murder and suicide is something you want to avoid. But now under the new laws of this new mayor, it's completely okay and legal.
Yeah, it's like, is suicide even a good thing? Like, from our instinctive morals, we say, no, it's, like, not a good thing. You should live. You should enjoy life. You should embrace everything it is. But some people don't feel that way. It's like, are they necessarily wrong? And how is, like, someone trying to navigate that, figure it out?
Yeah, humans are just too complex to have any black and white line of justice. It's just way too subjective.
Yes, I'm definitely interested to see, like, where will this take the moral person? Like, will he change his mind, or will he find a way to, like, reconcile what he's seen?
I think it's all going to depend on how the girl is able to convince people. Because if she has a solid story, like, he may eventually get convinced that, like, the suicide isn't the main aspect that he needs to be worried about.
Oh, maybe he'll even commit suicide in the end. That would be a very interesting way to do it, or at least a very different way.
I might be okay with that, as long as she takes over as, like, the main character, the main point of view afterwards.
Oh, yeah, I was thinking that'd be, like, how the series ends, but that could also be... Yeah, like, there's so much to her. Like, you got her in the interrogation, which is, like, my favorite scene of the show, just, like, how off she is.
Yeah, that was definitely a very thought-provoking scene. I do wish in that interrogation, though, they wouldn't have chopped it up. I wish they would have just given us the entire interrogation in one go.
Yeah, and that's something I noticed this, I think it was especially like episode 2, how they kept like giving us pieces of the, and then we kind of had to like put it all together ourselves, which I don't feel it worked as well as it could have.
Yeah, for as complex and as much detail as you had to follow, it just made it that much harder.
Yeah, it's like, I get the point of doing a scene that way, but it's like, you have to make sure your payoff is worth the confusion to the viewer.
Yeah, and another thing I want to mention about our mysterious woman here, how is she just able to shapeshift into whoever she wants?
Yeah, that's another question. Like, is it like a supernatural thing that she's doing, and does that tie into the people dying and all that, or is she just like really good at disguises?
Yeah, I don't know, but this show just has so much to it.
Oh, it does. Very suspenseful, very much a thriller, and I'm looking forward to getting more into this. So thank you everyone for taking the time to watch our video. Unseen Whisper, you want to tell us about your channel, where they can find you and all that?
Yeah, you can find me under Unseen Whispers. Hopefully it gets linked in the description if I'm lucky in this video.
If I don't, please remind me, because I sometimes forget things.
But either way, I know here on this channel you guys do more reviews and discussions. On my channel, it's more quick and to the point, just like recommendations or like just fun little details you missed during shows. So my videos tend to be short and concise compared to this channel.
Yeah, like I will rant about Symphogear for like 40 minutes with my friend. Yeah. I sometimes will do shorter videos too. One of those might be up soon. But yeah, check out Unseen Whispers. His Things You Missed in Astro Lost in Space was really cool, and I should check out his other videos too.
I would definitely appreciate it.
All right, so go check him out, and thank you everyone for watching.